dark, dark room. Images I remember. Hi there, welcome to Jam Toast. Thank you so much, Neecia, for being on the show. Welcome to the show. Being a student of Neecia's myself, it's absolutely like stunning to see you like this. I mean, I love the look. But how did that switch happen?
The switch, okay. Well, as you know, I trained in Western classical piano when I was really young. And my father actually did not allow me to listen to pop or rock music, you know, what was going on at that time until I was about 12. Because, you know, he thought that listening to some other genre would kind of disturb my understanding of classical music. So until the age of 12, I was not allowed to listen to that. But, you know, I got into classical music in a big way, of course, and studied in it, as you know, graduated from Australia with it, and started my teaching and, you know, concertizing profession. But ever since I was allowed to start listening to, you know, contemporary music, I mean, I loved it a lot. And even then, I've always wanted to do something like with a band or sing or, you know, something like that. So, but that opportunity never came up because of the situation I was in. I like to listen to, you know, slightly more melancholic and darker bands. I'm not talking about like metal, but people like The Cure, Sisters of Mercy, you know, Goth, The Mission, you know, things like that.
When I saw your first song, that the first single you released was Dark Room.
Dark Room, exactly.
And of course it was received with a lot of love, and it's beautiful, it's stunning. But there... knowing you, there would have been a lot of people who might not have received it too well as well, you know, with a little bit of shock. And what did people say? What amused you about people? People's reactions?
I wouldn't say that they didn't receive it well. They were very surprised, because for them it's like, you know, we know you as a concert pianist, and you know, you do you know, classical singing, and you know, this one. So how come you were suddenly doing this? To be very honest, they're a little bit scared, so they wouldn't ever say that, you know, we didn't take that quite well. They look very polite about it, you know. How come you didn't, you know, how come you went into this field? So, and I tell them, look, I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and better late than never, right? So once I put my mind to it, and then it kind of started off from there. And I, to be very honest, I'm not really bothered with what people may think or say. I just have to do what I have to do.
Tell me about your songwriting process a little bit.
Songwriting process. Now, all the songs on this album have been inspired by events, or basically the issues that are surrounding us today. Now, for example, actually Dark Room was not the first song I ever wrote. I actually wrote White Bone first. This was like years back, because at that time there was a big issue that was bothering me, and that was ivory poaching. Okay, so I was very, you know, disgusted and saddened by it. And because of that, you know, I just sat and the words came, the melody came. And, you know, so it was all about ivory poaching. But for this album, the whole version is completely different. So it's issues like this that kind of get me going with something or the other. So it's either social, women's issues, you know, personal experiences. So that's how the album was put together, really. It's not a feel-good album. Okay, it's not a feel-good album at all, and I'm currently writing for the second one, and that's not going to be feel-good either. Okay, because I don't know, for me personally, I think you just have to write through what you've gone through and to be able to express yourself. So it's not happy music, not at all.
And you've released an album. Tell me more about the album recording process.
It was like last year, from March till the middle of May, I had like 4 hours of sleep. Every single night I was doing recording, or, you know, doing the edits or doing the arrangements or whatever it was with all the other musicians. So it was like March to the middle of May, the whole album got done, including the printing and the, you know, the CD, you know, packaging, and, you know, the entire design and the mix and the master, everything. After that, I collapsed.
Wonderful. So now we come to this part that I've been waiting to talk about. Neecia is the first Indian to win Best Alternative Artist of the Year award at the IME Awards.
Yes,
so
that's
tell me about that experience.
It was the fifth edition of the awards. Okay, I was nominated thrice for different categories like Dark Room and The Other Side. And I thought, okay, this is the fifth year now and this is the third time I'm getting nominated. Why not go? You know, may as well. I've never been to the US before. So I thought, okay, let's go. Fortunately, you know, the lady at the counter of the US consulate took one look at me and said, all the best for your awards, honey. And said, your passport will be ready in two days. I said, thank you so much. So I made the travel all the way. It was held in a beautiful place called the Paramount Arts Center, which was where the first edition was held. So they wanted to do it there again for the fifth. So, you know, the evening started and I got to perform, by the way. I performed
Wow.
Dark Room. Yeah.
Amazing.
And, you know, it was so heartwarming for me, to be received well by, you know, my fellow nominees, not only in my category, but the other categories, you know, who came and appreciated Dark Room very much. So I was just sitting there and then it came to Alternative Artist of the Year. And then they said, you know, the nominees are such and such and such. And I'm like holding my, you know, camera and like, and then they announced and I'm like, oh, okay. I had a speech prepared though. So when I went up and I, you know, thanked everyone and told them about the fact that it was great that this is I'm the first Indian and the first Indian woman to win this award. And when I said, I hope this is an inspiration to women everywhere, like the ladies section of the crowd, they just started cheering. So it was really nice. Yeah, but it was such an honor to receive that.
Wonderful. Congratulations.
Yeah, yeah. Thank
again,
you so much.
If you had to give three tips to people out there, mm-hmm. to folks who are looking to, you know, put out an album, three tips basis your, you know,
okay.
album
mm-hmm.
and how you work towards
right.
it, what would they be?
See, to be very honest, Vidyaa, trying to get this album out, there were a lot of obstacles. Number one being money. And it really depends on what genre you're doing. I mean, if you're a band, you know, you have to make sure that everyone's really rehearsed and tied together so that, you know, you don't waste studio time. I know a lot of people who want to record, but they can't because of financial constraints. And, you know, unfortunately, in this country, there are not a lot of labels who would put their backing behind indie music, you know, because you know that the majority is basically Bollywood. So it is difficult. And I know a lot of people who are struggling. But for me personally, I don't basically let that get in the way. If I want to do something, I want.
So thank you so much, Neecia, for being on the show.
You're very welcome, Vidyaa. And it's so refreshing to see you in a different persona. Rather than being my student those many years ago, you know, and I'm so happy for you with what you're doing.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I can't tell you what an absolute joy it is for me to have you on the show. So, and my music teacher, guys, cannot contain it. But again, you've got to follow Neecia. We're going to see a lot more of Neecia. And I'll let Neecia tell you how you can follow her updates.
So I've got a page on Facebook. It's called The Majolly Project. You can also follow me on Twitter at Majolly Project. And the album, Please, my debut Goth album, is for sale also on iTunes and actually about 99 sites, including Amazon. So please, please do support independent music like mine by buying. Yeah, don't copy. Please do support independent music by buying. I'm not just talking about myself, but even for other bands and musicians as well. Buy the music. It really helps.
Thank you, guys. Buy the music, attend concerts. Thank you so much, Neecia.
You're welcome.
We love you.
Oh.
See you guys.
Bye.
dark, dark room. Images that flicker in a dark, dark room. Images I remember in a dark, dark room. Dark room, images I remember. There's a space between us. There's a space between. There's a space between us. There's a space between us. There's a space between.
Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am home again. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am whole again. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel I am young again. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am fun again. However far away, I will always love you. However long I stay, I will always love you. Whatever words I say, I will always love you. I will always love you. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am free again. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am clean again. However far away, I will always love you. However long I stay, I will always love you. Whatever words I say, I will always love you. I will always love you.
Just one drink and there's some people to meet ya. I think that you like them. I have to say we do, and I promise you in less than an hour we will honestly go. So why don't I just get you another while you just say hello? Clutching it tight, another glass in my hand, and my mouth and the smile's moving up as I stand. Close and too wide, and the smile's too bright. Breathing too deep, and my head's getting light. But the air is getting heavier, and it's closer, and it's starting to sway. And the hands on all my shoulders don't have names. Here I go again, falling into strangers, and it's only just 11. Stare like a child until someone slips in heaven. Taking on my knees just like a thousand times before. Yet time speaks that. And I'm just looking at the floor. Yeah, just looking at the floor. It like I get, like my life's going numb. I just keep moving my mouth, I just keep moving my feet. I say I love you to death, like I'm losing my breath. And all the smiles that I wear, and all the games that I play, and all the drinks that I mix, and I drink till I'm sick, and all the faces I make, and all the shapes that I throw, and all the people I how I feel inside.